Well, we've had a weekend to digest the tax plan from House Republicans. Here's what I think. Looks like Republicans wrote the business side, but it sure seems like Democrats wrote the new rules for individuals. First of all, business. Overall, business will pay less. Now, this is classic Republican policy. Let capitalism work. Bring back the trillions from overseas and let business make more profit. The economy will get help. The stock market gets another boost. This is the kind of thing we were expecting from the GOP. But we were also expecting tax relief for the people who pay most of the tax. That we didn't get. Right now, the top 1% of income earners pays about, what, 40% of all income taxes collected. If this tax plan goes through as is, the 1% will actually be paying a lot more. Think about it. Their top rate, 39.6%, it stays right there, 39.6, no cut. They will no longer be able to deduct their local income taxes, and they will lose at least some of their mortgage and property tax deductions too. The amount they pay to the Treasury will go up. Now, the 1% doesn't get much sympathy these days. They've been demonized for a generation. But unless this plan is changed, extra money flows to the government, not to the job creators. The economy misses out. Of course, there is a heavy dose of politics in all this. The Republicans seem to have bought the Democrat line about taxing the rich. And they bought the line that only tax increases can help the deficit. What nonsense. As the Wall Street Journal suggests, Hillary Clinton could have written this plan. Sum it up. This is a middle-class tax cut. Middle-class tax cut. Yes, it is. It is a business tax cut. Yes, it is. But overall, it's a tax increase for the 1%. And that means the GOP promise of a surge to 4% economic growth looks unlikely.